The mothership, 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 mothership connection is here. Excuse me, baby.
The Foster Jones Show.
Yeah, I did.
Yo, 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 P-Funketeers. Well, all right. P-Funketeers of the world unite. Yeah. It's the Funkster Jones Show.
Funkster Jones
from
Show.
P. Haven.
From P. Haven.
Featuring P. Funkster Jones.
P. Funkster Jones.
Oh, 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 oh. And Skeeter
Burdelli.
Hey, Funkster.
Yeah?
Don't leave out Scully Funkadelli. Never, my brother. You know I'm always watching you.
Well, all right.
It's the Funkster Jones Show.
Yes, it is.
From P. Haven.
P. Haven.
And we ready to kick this thing off.
We ready to kick this thing off.
Sit back, dig.
What we do it to you through your eyeballs.
Through your eyeballs.
And in your ear holes.
In your ear holes, baby.
Yo, yo, yo.
P. Funkster.
P. Funkster of the world.
You name, baby.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Forever funkin' on, baby.
Forever funkin' on, baby.
Yo, 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 P-Funketeers, P-Funketeers of the world unite. It's Funkster from P-Haven, a place where Funkster goes to free my mind so my behind can follow. You feel me? Nothing but the phone. But this time, it's the Funkster Jones P-Funkin' Funk and Fun Show, baby. P-Funkin' Funk and Fun Show, baby. Right here from P-Haven. And you know, to get right into it, you remember how you used to wake up on Saturday mornings when you were younger and you couldn't wait to wake up to watch the cartoons? Yeah, it was something we liked back in the day, like the Jacksons cartoon. Pink Panther, if you liked him. Hong Kong Phooey. Yeah! You know, just cartoons. And we always wished, if you were into P-Funk, you always wished that there was a funk cartoon. Man, I wish there was some funk cartoon or something back in the day. That would have been so awesome. But I'll tell you what, to start the show off, to kick it off right, we're going to take you to Funk Upon a Time. Funk Upon a Time. A little car funk tune, I call it, by Baptiste Jacquet and George Clinton. Woo! These characters right here, as you can see on my shirt, Star Child, Dr. Funkenstein, the Brides of Funkenstein, yeah, Starmon, they're all up in there. And even that unfunky sucker right there, I ain't got to tell you who he is, Sir Nose Devoid of Funk. What's the battle between Star Child and Sir Nose? Starts off with a catcher Star Child, then we take it from there. Sir Nose captures Star Child, then we take it from there. So let's get right into it, right here on the Funkster Jones Show. Yes, and we'll be back after you check this out. Yeah.
The tale begins with our hero Star Child being harassed by Sir Nose and the Noses.
Yeah.
have but one purpose, the spread of funky music throughout the galaxy and beyond.
A good evening. I do not attempt to adjust your radio. There is nothing wrong. We have taken control as to bring you this special show. We will return it to you as soon as you are grooving. A welcome to station WEFUNK, better known as We Funk, or deeper still, the Mothership Connection, home of the extraterrestrial brothers, dealers of funky music, P-Funk, Uncut Funk, The Bomb.
Coming to you directly from the Mothership, top of the chocolate milk, 500,000 kilowatts of P-Funk power. So kick back, dig, while we do it to you in your eardrums. Oh, me, I'm known as Lollipop Man, alias the long-haired sucker. My motto is...
seen Sir Nose Devoid the Funk? Tell him he will dance. He must dance. I'll shoot him with the bop gun. Pay attention.
I am Sir Nose Devoid the Funk.
When the syndrome is around, don't let your guard down, or you'll have to do go on the front. Delicious, we shall overcome. What you think is wrong with them? I still say the others more than the boy. I ought to shoot them with my pop gun.
Mothership Connection, blasting them with the outer space bop gun. Yeah, Sir Nose, you better run, sucker. But you see, at the end, Sir Nose still remained devoid of funk. Nose grew and everything. He was funking for a minute, though, with those Funkin' Donuts. Yeah, that was made way back in the 90s. Or maybe the two, no, not the 90s, I should say the 2000s. And Cliff Payne was the first one that I seen post that. It was from MySpace, believe it or not. So check it out. On and cracking. And that leads me to one thing. Remember the 70s, you remember the cartoons, so I know you remember the album covers. How we used to run to the store when a new record came out, especially when the artwork got to going crazy and funky. We were saying, make my funk the P-Funk, baby, because we had to have that artwork. Had to have it. And the first artist that I know, it was funking. I mean, giving up the funk and turning us on to things like a mug, Zeke, Geebies. You know, all those crazy type sayings, you know what I mean? His name was Pedro Bell. The late, great Pedro Bell. Thank you, brother. Thank you for everything you've done for the P-Funk. Because whatever you've done for the P-Funk, you've done for us because we loved it. And we love you for doing it. And speaking of Pedro Bell and those covers I was talking about, this is 1973 Cosmic Slop cover. Now, I gotta tell you, I don't know what you thought when you first saw this. When I saw this, I was like, what the freaking... What the freaking heck is this? Cosmic Slop. Teeth all messed up. I mean, just great. Beautiful. I mean, beautiful artwork, though. But you just wonder, like, what is going on with that? It was like the record drew you into the point where you couldn't wait to hear them. Yeah, so you'd be in the record store looking at this, you're like, hey, man, what the heck is going on? Yeah, they weren't open, so you couldn't really pour it out like this. But then you see the foreword by Pedro Bell. I mean, oh, it's awesome. The linear notes. I mean, just beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful artwork. Pedro Bell. P-Funk's basically first artist. Here you go. Pedro Bell. That's hype, man. That's hype. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Not only that, that's like some of Pedro Bell's early work. Let me show you one of the last pieces he done. He was funkin' till the day he died. Giving up the funk. Here's one of Pedro Bell's latest pieces. And y'all know this album. It's Axiom Funk. Woo, funk is so heavy sometimes. Can't hold it. Yeah, it's big time anyway. You know that. Axiom Funk. Scully Funkadelic. Yeah, Funk Chronomicon. What I like about this, about Pedro, is that you have all the instruments coming up out of the ground and the skulls. It's like, you know what, I equate that to like Funk Chronomicon, but I equate it to the spirits coming back up out of the ground because the funk goes, but it never goes anywhere. It's forever coming. So there it is. It's coming. Pedro Bell, some of his latest artwork, some of the last pieces he done. I had just blown up because, man, I just love that cover. I think that's so awesome. Pedro Bell, thank you, brother. Funk Chronomicon album. If you haven't got that album, go check that out. Because it's now on vinyl. It's now available on vinyl. Woo! That's what I'm talking about. Getting deep, baby. Getting deep. And speaking of P-Funk artwork, now y'all know Pedro drew for Funkadelic. Then we got to get to Parliament. You get to Parliament. Now there's cover. Their cover started off as real picture-like things. Real picture-like covers. Until they got into the cartoons. Or car funk tunes, I should say. And the artist's name is Overton Lloyd. Mr. Overton Lloyd. Overvision. You can go check it out. On Facebook. On Instagram. Yes. Overvision. Overton Lloyd. And you know what? His covers. Whew. Just like Pedro's. You couldn't help but be in a record store looking at those covers. It was crazy. It always made you want to buy the record. Speaking of Overton Lloyd and his magnificent covers, his magnificent artwork. Check it out. Check it out. Check it out.